Yo guys, what's up? Carlos here, and today we're going to talk about the pipe in week two in the wedding pipe. Is it worth the pull or not? Short answer, yes, it is definitely worth the pull. You see the spotlights already below me. We're going through them. We check the ranks and the tracks out. The value, we have wedding peach, party trampolines, or coin box. So we have party toad, we have the Gilded Prancer, the red taxi, the head honcho, really good cars. We have the royal parachute, the silver gold heart balloon glider, and the gift glider, also coin glider. It's definitely a good pipe. I'm in my free to play account. I will definitely pull with my free to play. I will be able to empty the pipe. I have at the moment 405 rubies. I will get another 10 from the two login bonus versions, and in case I need to empty the pipe, I will hopefully get rubies from the rank up. So I have the last hour of the tour time, so I need to get up early then if I need to empty it to pull the rest. Let's go through. We are starting with the drivers, and Wedding Peach is definitely one of the best drivers. Also, if you check the rundowns from Stutfish, for example, I guess she's still in the top three. Mine is level 2, so I have her already. But if I get her, level 3, level up, perfect. I would not say no. Triple Mushroom, that's a very nice item, very valuable. So that means with a low level driver, you can stall at the start and take a ticket, get a Mushroom or Triple Mushroom Frenzy, or in general, you can trigger a Triple Mushroom Frenzy from place 5 to 8 usually. So that's really valuable item. Even if it is more or less the same as a regular Mushroom, in case you get a Frenzy, but you have at least two good Frenzies, Mushroom and Triple Mushroom, to trigger. How many tracks do we have? And that's a lot. We have 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12. Ah, damn it, sorry. 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 2, 4, 18. 18 with level 1 and 2. 20, level 3. And 22, level 6. That is a lot. That's a lot. 22 tracks is really a lot. Do you have any city tracks here? Yeah, we have Berlin Byways, London. We have Los Angeles. That's 3. That's a lot. So 19 city less tracks left. So very, very valuable driver. Go for it. Next up is Party Trampoline. Party Trampoline is here. I don't have her. So that will be my next Coinbox driver I will get, which is really cool. I know a lot of people say she is not that valuable if you have the other Coinbox drivers, but you will never know what happens in the future. Nintendo kind of focuses on the Coinbox drivers, so I think it makes sense to have most as possible Coinbox drivers, especially if you go for rank or ACR. And yeah, so Coinbox, we don't need to talk about Coinbox if it is good or not. We have a 2, 4, 6, 2, 12, 2, 13, no, 15 tracks with level 1, 17 or 19. That is also good. It's not that good like the 20 plus drivers, but it's still good. We have here New York Minute, Los Angeles. We have London. We have another New York, New York, New York, that makes it 6. So we have 6 city tracks. That means we have 13 tracks left without being a city track. That definitely lowers the value, no doubt, compared to other Coinbox drivers. But still, if she is a tier 3 driver, and go for it, go for it. I know there are better Coinbox drivers out there. Maybe even Tuxedo Mario, aka Wedding Mario, will be maybe have a higher value in the future, which we don't know yet, but I think so. But go for it, go for it. You will have the fun with you with her. You will have the fun if you have her tier 3. Trust me, go for her. It's worth it. My Go Pass has her double capped, and she is very helpful in rank sometimes. Then we have Party Time Toad. I don't have it on my free to play as well, which is good. What is not good is the Mushroom Cannon. Mushroom Cannon makes only fun if you have a level 4 or higher Mushroom Cannon driver. Level 1, 2, and 3, it is a very bad item. I would almost say trash item. I don't like it. Even if you go straight, you can't really get a lot of the mushrooms. Mostly the bots take the mushrooms. So I'm definitely not a big fan of it. But besides that, let's check the tracks. And we see 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 13 tracks. Or 15 or 17. So I would say his value is not really that high. So if you only would pull for him, then I would say don't pull. So if I would pull the other two drives and I don't get towed, I would say, okay, I don't need to empty the pipe. But on the other side, I don't know how many tracks he overlaps with others. Since I have so many Comox drivers, I have already a high amount of tracks covered by any tier 3 drivers. But even here, there might be 1, 2, 3, maybe 4 tracks where I don't have a tier 3 driver, so it is helpful for my free-to-play account. Do we have any city tracks here? I see a lot of Toad Circuits here. Los Angeles, Berlin, that's it. So here's only 2 city tracks, which means 15 are left without being city track. So yeah, that's okay. That's a good average. Not really bad, but also not any top driver. Okay, so which means we have 1 very good driver, a very decent driver, which is Paddy Temperlin, and an average driver. So in total, absolute worth the pull just for the drivers. Now to the cards. Gilla Prancer, one of my really top 3 favorite cards. On my main account, it's level 7 and double cap, because it is really worth it. Let me just find it. Here we go. I don't have it on the free-to-play account. So another high-end new. That's cool. Jumpus Plus, which is one of my favorites besides the Mini Turbo Plus. We have 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 13 tracks. Level 1 and 2. Then 15 and then 17. That is for a card. Okay. Not even bad. Don't forget, we have so many cards. Like, too many cards. So a card has usually less tracks than a glider or a driver, because we have way more cards than gliders and drivers. 17 is not very good. There are also cards with like 20, 22 tracks, but 17 is absolutely decent. If you have it level 6, of course, level 1, 2, then we have 13. And we have Sydney, we have Tokyo, and that's it on city tracks. But you see, DK Pass, RT, Frape Solenti, that's long tracks, Rainbow Road, RT. Daisy Hills, Royal Raceway T. Those are long tracks, so the rally is definitely given here. So yeah, I will be happy if I get it, and I will get it. Then we have the Red Taxi. The Red Taxi was recently also very helpful. I don't have it on my free-to-play account, so that makes it already 4 high-ends I don't have. Dash Pedal Plus, okay, nice to have. Not my big favorite, but sometimes it is helpful. And we have here 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 11 tracks, 13 or 15. So that's less than a Gilla Prancer, which means it can get buffed, for sure, you never know. It's, in my opinion, better than average, because I have the feeling it is more often in rank up, somehow. Maybe I'm also completely wrong, but I feel like the Red Taxi helped me in the past on a couple of tracks. So I would still say a decent card. At least a big card. Not one of the tops, but so, yeah. Then we have Head Honcho. I know a couple of people who are a big fan of the Head Honcho. I have mine already. One. So I don't need to go specifically for it on that account. But even here, level up, always nice. We have Mini Turbo Plus. That is definitely my favorite. And the Head Honcho is 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 14, 15 tracks, level 1 and 2, or 17 or 19, which is absolutely cool. So like the Gilla Prancer, we had there, what, 17? Now we have 19. That is even better. And I don't see any city tracks. No, okay, I see 1 times Tokyo Blur. I hope I haven't overseen anything. And otherwise, and Tokyo Blur are okay, but still. Then we have 17 less without being city tracks. We see long tracks like Maple Tree Way, Geeky Pass T, Rainbow Road, the Alpha Fortress. So definitely also here, high value card. Makes absolute sense to go for it. I would even say that's the best card. I just don't have mine on my main account at a high level, so I did not use it that much, because I usually have the Gilla Prancer or other level 7 cards. But if that would be level 7 on my main account, I'm pretty sure I would use that more often. So yeah, nice card. I'm happy I have it already, but if I get it another level, at level 2, absolutely cool. And finally, we have the gliders. We have the Royal Parachute. And I remember the Royal Parachute was a long time very valuable. Not sure if it was recently, but it has a lot of tracks. I got it today already in my free pipe hole, a little spoiler. So I did not have it. I got it out of the pipe. So that was my first pull. I did already reset because the fact I can again go into it and I can empty the pipe. Maybe get it twice. That would be cool. So yeah, red shell plus. Oh, that's quite okay. That's good. Nice design. And we have a lot of tracks. 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 14, 16. Okay, we don't have that lot, that many tracks. That's the thing. I just talked today with, I think it was Antilev. I had in my mind that the Royal Parachute was very valuable. I think the Royal Parachute got buffed very early. But obviously, since a longer time, there was not a single extra track. Because 16 tracks for a glider, that is still okay. That's still a good average. But it's definitely not one of the top gliders. We have here Shoko Mountains, Mario Circuits, Daisy Hills T. At least no city track. So that means we stay at the 12, 14 or 16 tracks. But still, it is not bad. So it's definitely not a bad glider. But maybe the others are better. Let's check them. But so in my opinion, still worth the pull for it. The next one is the... theoretically, silver, gold, let's go row by row. Silver and gold hard glider. Do you have it? No, I don't have it. Bullet Bill Plus, which is good, especially if you go for coin box drivers, because when you're in first place and you want coin boxes, then you won't get a bullet pill. So it is better than Banana Plus, for example. And that is a great glider, definitely. We have here 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 2, 4, 18 tracks just. With level 1 and 2, 18 tracks, or 20 or 22. So that is a very high valuable glider. Do we have any city tracks here? I know Merry Mountain is not a city track, but Merry Mountain does also not happen that often. So let's count that in this kind of city track. Paris, 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 and Los Angeles. So inclusive Merry Mountain, we have 5 city or kind of city tracks. Then we have still 17 left. That is great. That's absolutely great. And the bullet bill plus nice optic. So that is a glider I definitely want in my collection. And last but not least, we have the gift glider. I didn't expect that, to be honest, because that is like so Christmas style. But it's nice that we have it in the pipe. Coin plus, that's always good. Still not that OP like a lot thing. So if you have a coin box driver, I would rather go with another glider. Because if you are front running, you don't want coins, you want boxes. So you want a glider which gives you the chance of getting other items a little bit more often. Like, yeah, bullet bill, which you don't get in first place, so you have to spot for a coin box. But still, a coin plus is nice. And how many tracks do we have here? 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 14 and 16. Also here, a good average. Since it is more a seasonal glider, I would still say it's okay. From all three gliders, I would almost say maybe the glider with the less value. But if I see the tracks, we have Luigi's Mansion, Rainbow Road. Okay, also Vancouver, New York, New York Mini. So 3 city tracks here already. Neo Bows, also Cousin Chuchi, Royal Raceway. Also here Merry Mountain 2 times. So long tracks, but I see 3 city tracks, 2 Merry Mountains, so let's say 5 tracks, which we don't have that often. And we have then only 2, 4, 6, 2, 4, 12, 16, 11 tracks left. So that's definitely below average, in my opinion. So from all 9 spotlights we have here, I would say those 2 I don't really need would be Party Time Toad and the Gift Glider. Average, we have the Royal Parachute, we have the Red Taxi. Maybe also Party Time, but I can't say that a coin box driver is average. And definitely top, I definitely want and need to pull, or want to pull for a Sweating Peach. So yeah, definitely Party Time Pauline, Gilla Prancer, Head Honcho, and the Silver Gold Hard Balloon Glider. And in total, overall, don't forget, we also get 3 regular high-ends, so that makes it 12 high-ends in a 100 pipe. If you have at least 400 rubies, and again, I need to say that specifically because so many people still ask me, should I pull or not? I have saved up 150, 200 rubies, 250. Don't do that. Don't pull if you don't have at least 400 rubies that you can almost empty the pile. So if you have that, go for it, pull. I have 405. I will get hopefully more rubies from the rank up, so I can even empty it in the last hour of the tour. So it makes sense. I will get a lot new stuff. I will get level ups, so that helps my free to play account to grow, to be better. If I had 250 rubies, I would not pull. The chance that I get high ends is high on that pipe, but it can also be trash and you get only two high ends and your account doesn't get better. Why do you want to pull? You want to pull because you want a better account. So save your rubies. I know it takes a while. I saved my rubies now for like at least 2 months, I think. So I did not pull anything besides the free pulls. Sure, I would like to pull sometimes. I wanted to pull, I could also pull for Tuxedo Mario. But the pipe has only 3 plus 3 high ends. So that pipe here has a better value, plus also Coinbox Driver. If I had 250 rubies again, on a regular pipe, never, but also on that special pipe, and I will call that a special pipe, save your rubies. Save your rubies for like 2 months, 3 months, and wait for a special pipe, wait for a pipe like here, 12 hands, and then you can go all in. You get your 10, 12, or maybe did we had a 12 hand pipe already, also, the anniversary pipe. Don't forget, from now on, if you don't have rubies, save your rubies until the anniversary tour. That is what I will do with my free-to-play account. Anniversary is in like 3 months, I think. July, August, September. Yeah, in 3 months, we have second year anniversary. In 3 months, I will be back at, I don't know, 400, 500 rubies. So I know already I can empty the anniversary pipe with my free-to-play account. And my free-to-play account will get a way higher improvement than if I would pull every pipe 1 times 10, and I get maybe 1, 2, or 3 times a high end, but that's it. In the anniversary, I get maybe 9 high ends, maybe 9 new high ends, or at least 2, 3 new ones and a couple upgrades. That is how it works. That is how you can improve your account. You see, that account is now 8.5 months young. I will bring a video about my loadout and everything around in the next days. So yeah, but as a general tip, I give you like on every stream, and I will give it to you again. If you have not at least 400 rubies, don't pull. If you have 400 rubies, go for it. That was the should you pull or not. Thanks for watching. Let me know in the comments if you're going to pull. Let me know what you have pulled. Also, let me know if you are going to pull if you have less than 300 rubies. Then we can talk. But yeah, I can just advise you. No? If you do it, it's your rubies, your account. But then don't complain that you don't get anything. I see so many comments, oh, I pulled 3 times 10 and I just got trash. Yes, of course, because that is gambling. Pipe pulls are gambling, and if you can't empty it, you can't expect anything. You see posts, oh, I got 3, 4, 5 high ends, but that's 1 of 10,000 or 5 of 10,000, whatever. But most of you, including me, if you check my pipe pulls, sometimes you need to empty a pipe to get the high ends in the spotlights. And if I need to empty the pipe, okay, then it's okay because 12 high ends. And I expect that I need to empty the pipe, and if I don't need to empty it, then it's good. If I empty it, or if I need to empty it, then I know at least, okay, I have the rubies to do it. That's it. Carlos out. See you in the pipe pulls. Bye-bye.